Audrey DeCruz still can't believe her mother is gone.
It was a nightmare to lose my mom.
The victim of an outbreak at this Ontario long-term care home, Teresa DeCruz got COVID from a sick roommate.
I feel like our elderly, not just my mom, but all the other people that were in that home, were treated like they're dispensable.
We are learning more about the coronavirus responsible for the pandemic and its victims. 80 to 90% of the 10,000 deaths came in the first wave. More than 70% have been people over 80 years, mostly in long-term care. More than 90% of the deaths were in Ontario and Quebec. In this second wave, more young people are getting sick, but most of the victims remain people over 70 years.
The death rates now in the second wave or the rebound peak are overall lower, and there's fewer of them occurring in the long-term care homes because more precautions are being taken.
For example, we're doing a better job of reducing transmission into nursing homes from staff. And thanks to improved contact tracing and testing, we see more of the virus than before. But what we see is sobering, record-breaking case numbers, rising deaths.
He came from work, and he just talked with his roommate that he's not feeling well.
Andrew Ring's cousin worked at a poultry plant in Manitoba. 42-year-old Gabriel Deng sent money to his family in South Sudan.
I'm going to miss him.
Describing the pandemic as a horrific national tragedy, the Prime Minister had this warning.
We need to know that there are more tragedies to come.
Experts say preventing deaths depends on how well we protect the most vulnerable. And we'll see that in the coming weeks and months in the number of cases presenting to hospital. Karen Pauls, CBC News, Winnipeg.